Hi there, and welcome to statistics class. This is both an AP and a dual credit class. So let me give you a little rundown, little structure of our class. So hopefully you get a tiny insight onto what we're doing here in this class. And if you have questions, feel free to ask your students or even reach out to me and I'll try to fill you in as best I can. First of all, about myself. I am originally from Texas, Houston, Texas, where I grew up. I went to school in at University of Texas. And after that, I ended up at USAA Life Insurance doing some actuary work there. Decided to get into teaching. My wife and I moved up to the Portland area. I went to Lewis and Clark College. And while I was there getting my master's degree, I was placed here to do my student teaching. And I've been here. This is my 18th year teaching at Lake Ridge High School. And I teach both statistics as a dual credit AP class, and I teach advanced algebra as a dual credit math 111 class. So get to work closely with Portland Community College through the classes that I teach. Besides that, I got three kids of my own at home. I coach swimming and I just kind of try to be a dad sometimes. So that's a little bit about myself. So you kind of have a little lay of the land on what we're doing here. Let's talk a little class structure, if you will. So this is kind of what our class structure typically looks like is we do warm-up problems at the beginning. I kind of go through the lesson plans. We do some practice problem and I try to give some work time. Now that's all kind of odd because I also post videos ahead of the class so that we do a little bit of a flipped classroom. So the students always have a chance to take some notes before they come in class. So as we start working on things, it's starting to click and they kind of get it twice. Now, I don't go as in depth. My videos before you come into class gives you a little more depth. And what I'm doing in class is we're doing some problems together. I'm kind of reiterating some things from the video, from the notes. And then I always want to give work time. And we have a couple platforms that we do our assignments on. One is called My Open Math, and the other one is Khan Academy. Both of those help give us different perspectives and ideas, the types of problems that we're looking for. And it just gives us a depth of knowledge that hopefully we get by the time assessments roll around. So that's kind of the class structure. So we always get that chance to do just enough work and ask questions in class. And that is my ultimate goal is I want to be there to answer questions for the students, which is why we try to front load some of the material online ahead of time before class starts, right? So that's a little bit of the class structure, just so you got a little bit of an idea of what the students are walking into. Let's look at the grade breakdown real quick, just so you have a semblance of what's going on. The classwork homework accounts for 25% of the grade. So a decent chunk of the grade, but obviously a lot more falls on the assessments. But here's the nice thing about the assessments, that's 50% of the grade. The assessments come in multiple pieces. They come in some quizzes along the way. They come in a partner data set problem that they do for every unit. They come from both the Khan Academy and the My Open Math. And then it comes from a written assessment part. So there's multiple pieces there that help us to kind of really get a good understanding on what is happening in this class. So the assessments is built over multiple different platforms put together for an assessment grade. So they're all equal 100 points roughly every unit, right? And if you go into Google Classroom or you ask your students about it, they'll kind of tell you kind of how that assessment looks to them. And then we do have a final at the end of the semesters. And that those finals count for 25% of that semester grade. And that is part of our dual credit commitment for that. So that's what the Portland Community College asks that we do. So that is where we set our final percentage at, but we'll kind of make sure we're prepped them so that they're ready for that. So then the kind of the final piece comes from just this dual credit versus an AP exam. Now, both of those are fantastic options in order to find credit. So let me kind of detail out the difference between the two. First of all, Portland Community College, it is through the community college, which is an accredited college, the same accreditation that accredits Oregon State, University of Oregon, University of Washington, Boise State, University of Utah, all of these, like in the Northwest area, we're all accredited by the same accreditation company. So with that, if you got Math 243 and Math 244, which are what our classes cover at Portland Community College, it is highly transferable to all these major universities out there, right? So this is a great way to go. And I encourage all kids to sign up for this credit and get that credit. And if you get an A or a B in this class that we get at Portland Community College, it transfers over super nicely to many other community colleges and many, many other four-year colleges as well. It costs the student $0 to do it. So yes, do it. It's an absolutely great thing to have in your back pocket. Now the AP exam, it's in May this year. It is a test, it's a 3-hour test and it costs $80. Now there is a deadline, October 29th. We need to decide, I'm in to pay the $80 or you wanna withdraw so you don't get charged any money by October 29th. But once we're in, if we're gonna take that AP exam, that also can get you college credit. And that is highly transferable as well. And that's kind of a little more transferable to some like obscure colleges on the East Coast, international colleges. They know what the AP exam is, so they kind of take that credit. Typically, you have to get a 4 or 5 on that exam in order to get that credit transferred over. Some colleges will take a 3 from that exam. So these two are kind of the same in a sense. The AP probably has more knownness across the world because its standards are very clearly written out. Where Portland Community College, most colleges in the US take that as a credit. Sometimes they have to look and see, are we teaching the same thing that they would teach at their college, right? They just need to see, make sure they align. And if they do, they're like, sure, we'll give you the credit for it as long as you got an A or B in that class. So these are our two options. We won't register for Portland Community College until November for the first semester and then until April for the second semester. And then this AP exam, if we're going to take the AP exam, we need to know by October 29th a yes or no in order to make sure we're registered. Now, students can take both so that you always have your options at the end of the year on which one you want to present to your college, right? So I would highly recommend that we do both. If you don't feel like you're a great test taker or you've already like, I know that I'm going to, especially if you're going to University of Oregon, Oregon State, Southern Oregon, Linfield, anything in the state of Oregon, this is kind of a no-brainer. It's going to transfer over real nicely as long as you get an A or B, okay? So there's a few things. If you got more questions, reach out to me. I can kind of help with that there. But hopefully this gives you just a small glimpse at what we do in this class and what it's built on. All right. Feel free to reach me via my email or, ask some questions through your student. They can ask the questions for you and we can try to get them back to you. All right. Y'all have a great day and I hope to see you soon.